So hello, I would like to welcome you in my new video. This video is going to be about meditation. And also, if you're new here, I would like to welcome you on my channel. And if you're interested in topics from self-help and psychology and personal development, you can subscribe to my channel. I post regularly. And so now I will get straight to my topic. You may be wondering why I would make a video about meditation, because there are plenty of videos about meditation. But I'm gonna do it from my own perspective and my own angle, because a lot of the times when I wanted to start with meditation, I would watch some meditation video and I would kind of fail, because it's really hard to incorporate meditation into your daily practice and do it daily and make it a habit. And I failed a lot of the times, and so I wanted to give you my perspective on this and how you actually can implement meditation successfully in your daily life, and how I personally did it after many trials and fails. And so if you will find any inspiration in this, I will be really, really glad. And so that's gonna be the point of my video. I'm gonna do it a little differently. I'm gonna approach meditation a little differently than what I saw on the internet. And so, I actually got inspired for this video because one of my friends, he actually asked me, how do I meditate? And it seemed like a strange question for me, but when I started to thinking about it more, I realized that I already spoke about meditation here on my channel in my video about mental detox. I will link it for you down below. But I didn't explain what do I mean by meditation and how you can practically do it. Because a lot of the times when somebody says meditation, people usually imagine that if you want to meditate, you have to be always by yourself, you have to find a quiet place, you have to sit with your back straight or in a lotus or half lotus, and you have to have enough time for that, at least like 20 minutes of your time, and you have to do it regularly every single day, and only in this way you will see some results and benefits. I agree only with the last statement. I think it's really important to do it every single day and make it a habit, but the other statements, I don't really agree with them, and I will tell you why. When I was starting with meditations, I always had a hard time finding a place for that in my schedule, because if you go to work or if you go to school, if you try to exercise, if you sometimes maybe see your friends, if you cook for yourself, or if you have plenty other activities, it might be really difficult to squeeze like 20 minutes every single day just for meditation, because sometimes you don't even if you start doing it, you don't see the results immediately. You will see the results only after some time. And maybe you wonder, why should I even do this? I don't see results. It's a plenty of time. It makes me irritated. I don't want to do it. Well, the reasons why you should do meditation, in my opinion, is that it can help you calm you down very much, especially in the today's world where we live in a kind of environment where you are always expected to be doing million things at once. If you are working in some company, then you will probably know what I'm talking about, where you are expected to be replying to your emails, to be constantly on the phone, to be talking to your colleagues if you are working in open space. I also made a video about open space, so I will also link it for you down below. And about the troubles you might encounter. But I think meditation is important because it's not a healthy lifestyle. If you are supposed to constantly jump from one thing to another, and if you do it over a longer period of time, it can bring you a lot of stress in your life. And it's really great if you learn how to center yourself back down and be able to focus on one thing. You know, don't you find it strange that we are not used to be focused on one thing anymore, that it's just so difficult? It shouldn't be this difficult. And meditation is good for when you are extremely stressed out and you wanna have some peace of mind. And also if you have severe problems like anxiety or depression or anything like that, then it's also great, but you don't even have to have severe problems. You can be just a regular person who doesn't have any severe problems but just want to calm yourself down. And for this, I actually think that it's best if you meditate, and this is how I personally do it, and I didn't see this anywhere else that people would be talking about this in this way, that I actually learned to meditate despite the circumstances which I have. I learned to meditate even in the most uncomfortable situations. You know, because always I had a meditation in my head connected to the fact that I have to find a quiet space and I have to be by myself. But when you actually incorporate meditation in your daily life in a way that you are maybe somewhere waiting for a train, or you are waiting for a bus, or you are at the doctor's, or you are in a supermarket, in a line in a supermarket, and you learn how to meditate in these places packed with people, then you are on the best track you can possibly be. Because what you learn is you will learn to calm yourself down even in the most stressful situations. And you will learn that you don't have to wait for some ideal or perfect circumstance where you can be by yourself in the nature and there is a waterfall and you can meditate in front of the waterfall or something like that. Because I actually personally learned how to meditate in these little windows of time which I have during the day. And now I actually, when I'm waiting at a line in a supermarket and people get really nervous and freaked out around me that it's just taking so long, I actually learned how to peace myself down so much that I just meditate when I'm in the line. I just stand in the line, I breathe deeply in and out, I center myself down, I calm myself down, and I just start breathing. Maybe I will even close my eyes, you know, you don't have to close your eyes. You can have your eyes like open and focus on some like point, like on the floor or on the wall, or take a fixed point and look at that and maybe change the point from time to time, or just don't look at anything particular at all, just breathe in and out and calm yourself down. That's like my number one technique when I want to center myself in stressful situations, is that I just simply focus on my breath. There's just, I think, from all the meditations technique that I ever learned about, I think that when push comes to show, the focus on your breath is the best thing, at least for me. It's like you don't have to think about something complicated. Your breath is always with you, and it's so healthy to be trying to make your breathings longer. It's so beneficial for your body to taking getting oxygen in your cells. And sometimes we just tend to breathe really on the surface, and it's really so unhealthy. And so I think breathing is the best thing you can possibly do. And so like this, you can actually meditate. Like I said, even when you are waiting for something, even if you're traveling on a train or on a plane or anywhere, you can just sit down and just try to center yourself for a couple minutes. And so like this, you will learn how to calm yourself down much more efficiently than if you were just waiting for the perfect moment when you're going to be by yourself in your room or anywhere else. Because these moments, it's not like they don't ever come, but they are really kind of rare. And a lot of the times what's going to be more often in your life is that you're going to be in stressful situations. And if you only learn how to meditate when you have perfect circumstance, then you will not learn how to meditate when you have the daily circumstance, you know. If you learn how to meditate in a stressful environment, then meditating when you are by yourself in a calm environment, it's going to be a piece of cake for you. That's like this message of my video. You don't have to wait for perfect circumstances. In fact, I would discourage you from waiting for perfect circumstances, and I would just learn how to calm yourself down anywhere, anytime, with like very limited amount of time which you have. Because it's not true that you have to meditate every single day for an hour, otherwise it doesn't count. I think it's good to keep this habit of meditation. Even if you have just 1 minute or 2 minutes, just do it for 1 or 2 minutes. The next day, you may be gonna have more time, so you're gonna do it for 20 minutes. And then the next day, you're again not gonna have enough time, so you again are gonna do it for like 5 minutes when you are standing at a line somewhere. But important thing is to remind yourself to do it every single day, even if you do it for 1 minute. But even if you do it for 1 minute, you're going to keep the habit. At least you're going to keep the habit. Don't underestimate how amazing and beneficial it is if you keep at least the habit going. And If I should tell you my personal experience with meditation, I would tell you that I am not an expert on it. It's not like I can calm myself down and be like, clear my head completely and be totally zen and all these things. I actually have really problems with calming myself down. I've been working for it for like a year or two now, I think, and I would say that I'm making some progress along with yoga. I'm doing yoga as well, and yoga is also about like focusing on what is going on in your body, but it's just super difficult, and I'm one of those people who was always running from one thing to another, and so calming myself down and focusing on one thing is just super hard for me. But I just do my best, and I just really do the meditation every single day. Even if I don't have enough time for that, I still do it for a couple minutes, and it's just been working really well for me. And I really worked on calming myself down, especially when I'm really stressed out about some events in my life, or I have a lot of things to do, so I meditate for a little bit and then I go do my things. And maybe I will make follow-up videos on meditation. Well, for sure I will make follow-up videos, because I feel like there are plenty other techniques which you can use. But for today, I just wanted to let you know about this, that don't wait for the perfect circumstances and learn how to calm yourself down even in the most stressful situations. That is basically the message of my video. And also, this is like the overall message of my channel, is that I think it's really important to work on yourself continuously, because if you're not going to work on yourself and develop yourself, then I think it's going to make your life slowly like worse, and you're going to encounter all these problems. They're gonna pile up and you're not gonna know how to deal with them. I think it's really good to be developing yourself continuously. I do it because it's really fun, but also it's extremely beneficial, and you can also do it by simple meditation every single day for a couple minutes, and you're gonna see amazing benefits. But I gotta warn you, it's not gonna be immediately, and I even think that when you start doing meditation, it's gonna maybe irritate you, because it's going to be super difficult for you if you're not used to that. And especially in these cases, it's good to do it for like a little while. You don't have to do it for like half an hour or anything like that. If you have any questions about this topic, please write me below in the comments. I will be so happy to read them and answer them. And know that I will make another videos about meditation, so if you're confused about anything, I will think about what might have been confusing about this video, and I will improve it in the future. And also, if you enjoyed this video, you can give it a like or subscribe to my channel, and I hope you will try at least a couple times before you completely dismiss it, but try at least a couple times to do meditation. And that's everything for me for today's video. So have a nice now, and I will see you next week with my next video. Bye.